Hello, I'm Karl from Klingenspiel Vienna, and we'd like to show you a few things about the cavazione in Italian reiki. Since I'm an old man, I need some paper because I don't remember all that stuff. Based on Ridolfo Capoferro, first some basics. A cavazione is a circular motion of the sword. To be able to perform a cavazione fast and with control, you should not grip your sword very tightly, but rather very loosely, and your index finger should not be held tightly around the cross guard. Should rather be relaxed so that you can easily move your sword from the wrist. If you grip it too tightly, this is not as easy or fast as possible. It is done to counter the stringere and is a motion where the sword returns to the place it was before. Und mit Konterkavation gleich weiter. There are a few aspects which are important, which are you have to return to a position of safety or dominance over the opponent's sword, and you have to take care of the ratio of debole and forte and of your own cover. Capoferro warns you to not attack directly with the cavazione in the first tempo. In the first tempo, without taking care of controlling the opponent's blade, your attack might be fast, but your point is going through the forte of your opponent's blade, which allows him to parry your attack. The right way would be to take care to control the opponent's sword in the first tempo, now I need a mask, and attack that.
Ich stirb wieder.
Na, du machst das richtig diesmal. Now I can't parry his attack. Capoferro mentions that you can do the cavazione above the opponent's sword or under the opponent's sword. Thank you. Cavation above the opponent's sword can also be done as a mezzo cavatione on some occasions, like this. As is shown on plate 13 in Capoferro, I gain my opponent's blade on the outside, he performs the cavatione below my sword, and during that tempo, I make a mezzo cavatione over his sword. Cavazione can be done with going forward or with going backwards. Let me show you the forward part now, where my opponent gains measure during his cavazione. Backward is also a possibility, especially when I would be too close during my cavatione. The reason for going backwards during the cavazione is, if I wouldn't do it at this measure, my opponent would could easily push against my sword and defeat my cavazione. If I move back with my body or with my feet a little bit, then this will not happen. In this case, the cavazione from my side is done in two tempi. In the first tempi, I move it below my opponent's sword to get out of his control, and only in the second tempo I gain his sword again. Of course, lowering the sword could give my opponent an opportunity to attack above my sword. But as you see, this might be dangerous, and it is quite easy to defeat. What you should not do for a cavatione is to move your sword from the arm. This is too slow, and you can't use the arm for another motion which might be necessary. I show it once in the wrong way. As you see, it is quite slow if I move my whole arm. I should rather do it just from the wrist. The arm moves only to position my sword in the right way, not for doing the circular motion. This is done just from the wrist. Now an exercise. I gain my opponent's sword. He performs a cavazione. I do a contro cavazione. When I have control, I move a little bit closer. He makes another cavazione. I shut his sword out. Put my right foot forward. And now I have gained his last step. Whenever I gained control in a cavazione, I can safely move in to gain my superstrappa or to come closer to my opponent. But I should only move my feet if I have control. While I do the cavazione, I should not go forward. Once again. Now my opponent will use the cavazione below in two tempi so that I cannot attack at the end. Same as now. I move closer. Mit Maske. Because my opponent now moves backward during his last cavazione, he has enough time and measure to gain control of my sword again. If he wouldn't do that, I would hit him. One crucial point here is that during the time my opponent moves his sword below my sword, I might try to attack above.
It's a ratio.
As you see, it doesn't work. No matter if I try to attack below or above his sword, he has enough time to do another action. One thing that happens quite often with doing cavazione and contro cavazione and so on, if both do not move, we end up somewhere rather high, which is awkward. Now this is no good position anymore. But what can I do? If I think there is enough tempo to attack below, this might be an opportunity. Let's see if this works in that case. Du machst einfach, was du glaubst, das richtig ist. Mm-hmm. as you see, this doesn't work quite well. I can do something else. I just drop my sword below my opponent's guard, and now he has to do something, which gives me a tempo to gain his sword. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this and try this at home.